Many, many centuries ago, there was a young man, and he was a really great hunter. And it came time for him to marry. And he looked and he looked and he looked, but he could not find a woman within his own tribe. So he was out hunting one day, and he went down by the stream. And down by the stream, he met this young woman. She was a beautiful young woman, and he'd never seen her before. And he asked her, "Well, where do you come from?" And she says, "Well, I'm from the Buffalo tribe." Back in the old days, we could shapeshift back and forth between animals and humans and do all kinds of magical things before we shut all that down. And so he fell madly in love with her, and he asked her, "Well, will you come and will you live with me and my people, and will you be my wife?" And she said yes. So she went and she lived with him. But his people were very, they just couldn't get used to her ways because she was just a little bit different. So they made her very uncomfortable. And after a time period, the couple had a young son, and it flowed over into the son's life, too, that he was just a little bit different. You know, you can't really like them because they live on the next block over or something, you know, things like we see now. And so finally, she and the child decided they would go back to her people. And the young man was, no, I can't live without you. And she's like, look, we can't live like this. We have to go where we can be who we are. And so in the middle of the night, one night, while he was sleeping, they got up and they left. And he got up the next morning, and he started tracking them. And he came to this place, and he saw this young buffalo standing on the horizon. And he recognized that as his son. And the young buffalo came running down to meet him. And the young buffalo says, "Father, mother says you must go back. If you go to her people will kill you because of the way your people treated us. And we love you, and we do not wish for this to happen." So the father says, "No, I must follow you." And the young buffalo says, "No, father, you must return home." And then he runs off. And the buffalo run faster than the humans, so they got a little further away. Well, next day, the hunter finds again his son waiting for him on the horizon. And the wife comes, too. And they say, "Look, you cannot go with us." And they spend that evening with him, and he says, "Okay, I'll go home the next day," if they promise to spend that night with him. Well, in his head, he's really thinking, "No, I'm going to go too." And so he follows them, and the same thing happens the next day. And finally, they tell him, "All right, look, we've got this plan. You're going to be tested. When you get to the buffalo people, you're going to be tested." And so what they do is they devise a plan because he's going to have to pick his wife and son out of a whole herd of buffalo. And if he cannot do this, they're going to kill him. And so what they devise is that the younger buffalo is going to rub himself in the mud and have mud on him. And then the wife will have, like, leaves that she will roll in. So she'll have leaves in her hide. And so he can pick them out based on this. Well, sure enough, he arrives at the herd of buffalo. And when he arrives, the old man buffalo comes out. He's like, "Well, what do you want?" And he's like, "Well, I come in search of my wife and my son." And old man buffalo says, "Your people did not treat my daughter well. You must leave." And the young man says, "No, I cannot. I will not leave without my son and my wife. And you can kill me if need be." And so the buffalo gather around him. And finally, old buffalo says, "Okay, well, you need to then identify. If you love your wife so much, you will recognize her. Who is she?" And he looks around, and it's really hard in this herd of buffalo because there's thousands of buffaloes. And so he looks around, and he sees, finally, the buffalo with the leaves in her hair. And he says, this is my wife. And so he wins their approval a little bit. They're like, they're starting to gain respect for him because he has the knowing within him. And so what they do is they say, "Okay, you must survive one more test. You must demonstrate to us that you have the courage to face your own fear." And in humans, the biggest fear usually is death. What we don't know until we actually confront that fear is that our fear is not so much about death, but actually about living. So what happens is they create a circle around the young warrior, and all the buffalo come charging in on him, and they run until they hit horns. And they clap right in the middle. And the young warrior is squashed between their horns, and he falls to the ground. And everybody backs up, and they watch. And this was his moment of death. And what he does is he transforms because he has confronted his own fear of his death, of his own fear about being alive and showing others who he truly is and his nature. because he has confronted this, he is transformed into a buffalo, and he is allowed to live in harmony there with the buffalo tribe. We are confronting that fear. Our fear is not about not succeeding. Our fear is not a failure, though that is what we try to convince ourselves of. Our fear is about fulfilling our full potential and who we actually can be.
Living.
Yes.
That's what it sounds like.
That's what it's about.
Okay, so to hear more of these stories and read about them, you can get the book Legends and Prophecies of the Kiro Apache, Tales for Healing and Renewal. And I want to thank you, Maria, for joining us on Full Circle.
Oh, well, thank you so very much. I had a good time.